Explains why you're not sleeping with any dogs.
Hey, we're live! Yay!
Awkward.
You don't need to know what we were talking about before we went live.
You especially don't want to know this time.
We were talking about the charities we donate money to.
It's true. As always, in the chat, let us know if things are working or if you can hear us. Someone says hello from Wrigleyville.
Hey, Wrigleyville.
Oh, it's right, Ash, who just moved to town, I think.
Oh, really?
That's right. To work for Jellyvision. Yeah.
That's right.
Oh, yeah. So I'll see you soon, right?
That's right.
Oh, gosh. That might not be good.
Which is a good segue to introducing this week's guest, Ryan DiGiorgi.
Hey, guys. Yay. How are you? I was just across the street, and they told me to come down here. Now I'm doing it.
They didn't tell me. Didn't tell you why.
Nope.
Or what you're
nope.
doing.
This is a performance review.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, no.
So everyone in the stream, you tell us some things that Ryan has done well this year and badly this year.
I gotta tell you, I'm not liking how it's
actually. You're supposed to say things or like areas for improvement. No,
yeah.
Not bad.
Oh, yeah, frame it better.
That's
but for
right.
Ryan, we're gonna say bad.
Yes.
Well, I deserve it.
And then at the end of the stream, everyone's gonna vote whether Ryan should be fired.
Okay. Jizbin likes my shirt, which is the highest compliment.
That's
true. That's a good sign.
I'm
just going to be on your side.
He's very...
Yeah.
Oh, well, obviously.
Yeah.
Dodd says, go Ryan for existing.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's a big step for Ryan.
It's all I've done so far, and I appreciate the notification for it. Never trust the guy with no beard, says Fifth Room today. True. I actually shaved for this, which now I regret.
Yeah.
That was a mistake.
Oh, no, without a beard.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at this baby
face. It was a pretty bad beard.
But we are excited to have our first non-Tim guest for a while.
I know. A lot of Tims.
Yeah.
So we might accidentally call you Tim.
Isn't that your middle name?
That's fine. Ryan? Yeah, Ryan Tim. Ryan the Tim.
Tool man.
Ryan, yeah. Ryan the Tim Bin. DiGiorgi.
Jizz Tim. They called
Gross.
Me.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to chat with Ryan for a little bit. We're going to answer questions from the chat. And we're going to play Quiplash. If you are new to the stream, Quiplash isn't out yet, and this is the only place you can play it until it comes out.
But it's so
I haven't played
close.
Quiplash yet.
Oh, you haven't played
no,
it at all?
So I'm very excited.
It's so close you can touch it.
Mm. Yeah. I'm touching it right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tiro Flame says, is Quiplash ready yet? I want to play the damn game. It's ready for us and for you here, but it's not quite ready for
it's
us.
Ready to
also,
look
also
at.
We're out in the UK and other territories.
Oh, the party pack is.
Yeah, the party pack is.
Is
not
that
Quiplash?
That would be
yeah. If we have any European or Australian or New Zealander viewers,
not Germans.
Anyone?
Not Germans.
Sorry, Germany.
Yeah.
I feel like we should just have
too many swastikas.
We should
party?
Have a yes. We should have a giant graphic.
We're also not in Israel.
Oh well.
I feel like we should have a giant graphic and sound effect occasionally that just comes up on the screen and says, "Sorry, Germany."
We, by far, disappoint Germans more than any other group of people as a company.
Wasn't Germany...
There's only about 15 people in Germany who are actually vocal.
And they're very vocal, and they're convinced that there's millions of them. They're all every single one of them thinks that they're representing
and
a million people.
You Don't Know Jack actually did... Like,
that's what
all
I was going to say.
All the You Don't Know Jacks that we did in foreign territories, Germany was number one. We sold a shit ton of them.
Wasn't there like a German version of Jack?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
That's impressive.
I like this. I just saw someone posted on the Facebook page. They're angry because you don't put post-stream times in Eastern time, which is true. Whoever did not abuse him, you're an absolute saint for not verbally berating
also,
him.
Also, it's not EST. We're currently in EDT. It's daylight time right now.
We didn't publicly verbally berate him, but we did privately in our own office, so don't worry.
We're really right.
Noi 2222 says we don't want to anger Germany. This is probably true.
Yeah, it's true.
We've seen what they can do.
We'll take our chance.
Should we take a moment to walk down the lane of Ryan DiGiorgi?
Walk down Ryan's lane?
You guys want us to leave for that?
All right.
Yeah.
Like halfway through that sentence, you realized how to
bring the camera in.
I did.
You just kept
I was
going.
Like, I have to finish this sentence.
I work at Jellyvision down the street, which is a sister company to Jackbox.
Mm-hmm.
When I started,
or as I sometimes refer to it, cousin company.
Cousin company. Kissing cousins?
Kissing cousins.
Company?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Yeah, you're like a weird uncle who's been on both sides of the family somehow.
You like married one sister and then got divorced and married the other one.
And then married your own sister?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. And I know I know the company on my lap.
Yeah, right. And no one's comfortable with it, but yeah.
Do your business cards say, I'm my own grandpa?
Yeah. Mine just says The Street. Any Ray Stevens. Yeah, no, I'm a writer at Jellyvision. I write marketing stuff. Fun marketing and solutions.
He's more than just a writer. He's a fantastic writer-director.
That's true. Mm-hmm. I do direct projects. So if anyone wants to know how to do that.
He's also the voice of our voicemail, if you call up Jellyvision.
Still?
Yes.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Should we call up Jellyvision?
Yeah, we probably should. And then see who we get.
They just don't know how to change it.
I think Bryn's at the front desk today, so we should ask her what she's up to.
Let's give them a call.
Because the person supposed to be at the front desk was hit by a car on their bike.
Wait.
Oh.
And he has a concussion. It's Kyle. He's okay, though. He's okay.
He has a concussion. Not Shelby.
Yeah, not Shelby. But Kyle is okay.
What happened to Eve? Is she not at the
He's upstairs. Admiral 117, I'm sure I'm mispronouncing that. Wait, Jellyvision exists today? I was under the... Well, just say.
You're trying to reach. Dial it now or spell by name. Press 7.
Yeah.
For sales, press 2.
Yeah.
For marketing or PR, press 3.
I think it gets faster.
Press 4.
Right? And he's like, we're not going to use this, right?
This gets pretty funny, actually.
Oh, does it?
Oh, it's one of these. This is the bit I'm most known for at Jellyfisher. Yeah, it really plays. I think it really plays on the stream.
You're not really... Ow! Please select your option.
Great. I think we missed the setup to that.
Yeah.
It goes on for a while.
People were just asking, saying, oh, Jellyvision exists. I thought Jackbox, blah, blah, blah. It's confusing in a relation. We sort of split up, and Jellyvision does more agency?
Well, no. Whereas Jellyvision as a company is a communication software company.
I see.
Alec knows the party line.
Let's definitely get into the inner workings of a company that isn't this one.
When I started at Jellyvision, we were all the same company.
Yes.
The company that made You Don't Know Jack was one of the same. We had different divisions, mm-hmm. and you guys split off into Jackbox, and there was other fun things that are going on. But
the Jizbin says, wow, this is exhilarating.
Hey, let's show some things that Ryan has done for Jackbox.
Yeah, games,
great. Just to prove that I should be on the stream, even though I don't.
Well, because these are... This is actually... One of my favorite You Don't Know Jack commercials from all time.
Yeah.
And you'll hear Ryan's voice on it.
He is. And you know what? It angers us to think of you drinking it. Okay, there it is. And hey, let's take it a step further. We despise you. The perfect cup of coffee. That's what we pour at High Horse Coffee House. But it's not for everyone. Frankly, your taste buds probably can't appreciate how complex and rich our coffee is. And you know what? It angers us to think of you drinking it. Okay, there it is. And hey, let's take it a step further. We despise you. Our coffee is f***ing amazing and complex, and it's like from another f***ing dimension, but it's wasted. It is wasted on you. I would rather pour our coffee on a pile of manure than let it touch your tongue. That's right. You rate lower than steaming manure piles, so stay away. You just stay away, or so help me, I won't be held responsible for my actions. So remember, that's High Horse Coffee House on Historic Mansion. No, you know what? F*** you.
That is I like the end of it the best.
Fifth Dream today says, I just noticed the 2-ear. I love when that sneaks up on you. It took me a long time as well.
How can you see anything else in that image?
Once you see it, you can't unsee it.
I had at least a week of nightmares after.
It doesn't look like an ear. It looks kind of like there's
a kind of... I wanted to start a tradition of gross covers for the... You don't hear Jacks.
So yeah.
Starting with the first one, and I kind of had to up it. The
ear was in the middle of the head, right?
The ear was in the middle of the head. And this one I thought, what would be worse than that? I couldn't just add another ear.
No.
That would have been two on the
nose. So you could...
Ear on the nose.
Yeah.
That's true.
That commercial is part of You Don't Hear Jack 2, which was only available to Quiplash backers. But You Don't Hear Jack 1, the original, is on Bandcamp, and you can go get it now. Jackboxgames.bandcamp.com.
Do I get money when they buy that?
No.
Great.
You actually lose
money. I don't even know if we lose money, to be honest.
CDF says, hoping that Volume 3 is a butt crack.
It'll be three butt cracks.
With an ear like wedged in there.
Oh.
Oh, God. Can we do something else?
That kind of makes a lot of sense, actually.
Oh, great. Now we've given Allard.
Stop making sense.
An idea.
To Allard.
What else should we listen to? Should we hear your story? I'm doing a horrible job.
Let's play Quiplash.
Yeah, let's play Quiplash. That's what everybody's here for.
If anybody wants to Google Roger and Ryan DiGiorgi, you can hear my story at some point. But we don't have to hear
it. Yeah, we'll get to that.
We'll get to it.
In a second.
All right. So.
Who's playing?
So everyone who can see the code in the window, as people like to try to do, go ahead. We're going to let Ryan get in first. Maybe I'll...
I do remember. We came to the lab and we played all our games. And everyone had so much fun.
I do remember that.
We haven't played Quiplash.
Whoops.
Yeah, maybe we should do that.
We will. We'll do it.
I know people want to play it.
You know, the interns are starting next week. Maybe we'll do it.
Were there any Quiplash backers at Jellyvision?
I backed Quiplash.
What?
Yeah.
What level were you?
The lowest possible. Actually, I backed it at a level where I didn't want it to be made. I'm not sure if that was.
Yeah.
I got in first.
Wait.
I kept misspelling Jackbox. Is that okay?
What does knock knock mean?
What are you talking about?
I don't know. Can't focus too much on the chat.
Yeah,
you go
it's
a little
true.
Crazy.
For people in the chat, I like to say what I think the code sounds like, and it sounds to me like OJack Horseman.
Yeah.
Or a popular TV show from the 70s without the first letter.
Who loves you, Jackbox?
We'll give it a second to see if anyone can get in from any of those.
Mr. Plum with his catchphrase, "Let's goo!"
Oh, someone figured it out.
Nice.
Good old pizza dog.
Pizza dog.
All right. The first three letters are OJA. Oh, okay. Forget it then.
You can always join the audience, so please do.
So it's me, Albert, and Evan, and the chat.
Usually,
yes.
Great.
And the world.
Romeo. I read that as Romeo on Julio. But it's probably not that. Romeo and Julia.
How many people are in there, Ben? Let me see. Like, no, on the actual stream.
80. Sit back and relax.
Should I say go?
Yeah, let's get this game going. We have a lot to do today.
This party started.
Horseman threw me off.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Hi there, I'm your host, Schmitty, and I'm kind of excited. Good. I'm just relieved that Mackenzie isn't playing after that stunt she pulled last week. Let's get to it.
So Phil is playing Schmitty.
Yes.
Canonical.
Phil and Schmitty Schmitterson.
That's cool.
Yeah, someone will need to update Schmitty's Wikipedia page. Alright, let's all put in our answers.
Put in two answers, Ryan, so pace yourself.
Exactly. I don't know how to... Oh. No, I'm kidding.
Today I have a phone that is almost completely dead. That's the worst when you're at a party and you want to play the game. And
the chargers are for it.
Is there a charger? Yeah, I don't have a charger with me. I'm not a four. I'm not someone who plans ahead.
I'm agonizing over it. This is like... It's great when Ben's behind you when you're trying to play this game. I've learned that. Instantly.
That's a really nice phone. What kind of phone is that?
Well, it's... Shut up!
So while we wait for people to put in their answers, what are some of the guests we have coming up next week? I believe we have the Octodad folks, right?
Yeah.
That'll be really awesome.
How many folks is that?
I don't know how many of them. I mean, I'm sure we're not going to have all of them over, but... couple of them are coming over. We'll play Octodad and Quiplash. I believe the week after that is Max from Cards Against Humanity.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can't remember the exact order.
Then I think we have John Teddy.
Oh, John Teddy from the AV Club. He's great.
Okay, it's time for some
and then we have one of the designers of Threes.
Yeah, I love Threes.
Ooh, Threes is great.
All right.
Okay. Oh, good old pie fuckers.
Morning Rises.
Yeah, I like the subtlety of Morning Rise. Is it bad to reveal what I'm voting for?
You are just one vote.
Okay.
So you can go ahead and say who you're voting
Thanks
for.
Thanks for keeping me grounded.
Tell Evan to scroll down. What does that mean?
What?
Come on. Thank you, 11 people.
Is it a Quiplash?
No.
That is a Quiplash.
Yeah!
Kaboosh!
Innes says, can barely hear game. but I guess.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's always something.
You're the artist. I can see the game.
Like, yeah. Yannis is right behind us here in the game.
Yeah, just come in here.
Yeah, yeah. Just get in here.
Time to vote.
Now people are telling you to scroll up. People just, I think they just want to control your scrolling.
I don't, what does that even mean?
I mean, they can scroll
up. They're not, they're just fucking with you at this point.
Yeah, I win with a complete concept.
Next up, come up with a name for the most difficult yoga pose known to mankind. It's voting time.
One over Phoenix.
Yes, those are both good, though.
Yeah. Now the game is too loud. Scroll sideways. I can't deal with it. Scroll diagonal up. Yes, the background music's been there for quite some time.
Yeah.
And next is the best way to tell if a tomato was ripe. Vote on your devices.
Yeah. Yeah. I think we all know the right answer. Mm-hmm. As chefs.
I feel like both of these answers are related.
Yeah, well, it depends on who gets to the tomato first.
As much as I love the audio in our game, I sort of err on the side of having the volume slightly too low rather than too high.
Okay, next
on a streamer in general?
On a streamer. In general, just blast it. Yeah. Let anyone in your party talk. Constantly shush them.
It's voting time.
I like the old school Jack reference.
Yeah.
I didn't see if I even... I wasn't paying attention. Did I win the last one? Good for me.
He's
good at figuring out the third letter.
Is that going to be the next Jackbox game, figuring out the codes to the current Jackbox?
It should be. We should have a code.
Something
game.
A talking doll probably should not say when you pull the string.
I kind of want to see the family-friendly mode all that time. We could turn that on next time we play.
Yeah,
it won't look that different.
It just tells you to go outside and play.
Yeah. I feel like it would look a lot like this.
But it might not have this question in it. Oh, no.
Oh, this question is pretty safe.
In family-friendly mode, you could still write something.
Oh, yeah. That's, you know, it's your family.
Yeah, that's right.
You can't control your family.
Yeah, it looks like...
Quiplash!
Oh, what a comeback.
I think
it's the use of punch.
Next in line, the best way to quickly blow $1 million.
Yeah. Situation makes things better.
It's voting time.
You only need $1 million to fund our Kickstarter, I promise.
Yeah, if you funded our Kickstarter for $1 million, something happened to Kickstarter. We didn't
quite. Are you eating secret candy from like under the desk?
Guys, there's not enough for everybody.
Stuff you found under the desk.
Where's
that? Support that.
In my hoodie pocket.
Anytime there's
like
next
candy
one,
from Paris,
the
Paris
best
like
news you could get today.
Oh yeah, lasagna, just
shove it
in my back.
Well, you never know when you're going to get a fire, right? You always
sure,
have
never
in
know.
Pockets,
yeah.
So you can leave.
Oh, that's me.
Which Tim?
Any of them.
Yeah.
We should, what's everyone's favorite Tim we've had on the stream?
Yeah, we've had three Tims.
Tim Ryder, Tim Sniffin, and Tim Seeley.
I watched Tim Seeley, and it was pretty great. Haha, it was me, and I still lost.
That's the truth.
Thanks, Alan.
You lost, but you also won.
But I also won because people didn't want Tim on the stream.
Hard to beat a pizza dog.
Oh, good. Less That's Tim on the stream. My favorite Tim was Tim. Thanks, Kevin.
How fast our chat's going? I feel like we're bored.
Oh, wow. Last place.
My favorite Tim on the stream is Tim Weldon.
It's now time for round two. Everything is worth double. All right, twice
here
as
we go.
Much.
More jokes.
Okay.
So those of us that aren't playing, Ben, what should we talk about while people are busy writing in their answers? Oh, well, it worked. Shut the door. So, hey, stream, what do you guys want to talk about while the rest of them write in their answers? Builder says, Ryan is just the worst at this game.
Yeah, that's true.
I like Mike Builder's office is right next to us, so he's just next to the door heckling us. Talk about Regis. Yeah, we have a Regis standee back there. He came in for the Who Wants to Be Millionaire game. Wonder if we could... Would we be able to play... would we be able to play a copy of the old Who Wants to Be Millionaire, or would we have to, like...
Yeah.
Yeah. Builder is in the chat. Yes, I believe so. He's sometimes here.
Nice job, pink hexagon.
We're still waiting on. You're running out of time, blue blob and pink blob.
Yes, play millionaire.
It takes so long to write his.
Let's start the show.
Not bird school. I went to work school.
Worst invention that starts with spray on.
You have to do it online.
Okay,
you wouldn't like it.
Is it like a wizard school kind of?
Yeah, you do get Robbie Coltrane to come and meet you personally.
That's true. Oh, Millionaire Third Edition was the best.
Wait a second. Oh, we didn't do that one.
Burn. How many editions did you do? Two or?
I was working at Disney for the first one.
The first one just about killed everybody, right?
Killed like two people.
Yeah,
let's
not get crazy.
They were selling it at
Target. Coming up next.
Hardware
stores? The good, the bad, the ugly was the good, the bad, the ugly.
It was legitimately like the most popular show on TV for like a month there or something.
A Socrates quote that nobody bothered to write down.
Who did the most work and who did the most effective work?
Yeah.
It's voting
Ben
time.
Did more work on this game. It's okay. I'll admit.
If you're looking at it and it's on the TV, I did it.
Oh, that's all I care about.
Yeah.
If it's behind the scenes and you can't see it, I did it.
Yeah.
Why would I care about something I can't see?
If it's words on the screen, if it's music, if it's art,
yeah.
Ben did it. Ben is also Pizza Dog.
Next one. Name the next big sexually transmitted
disease. I like the idea of the next big sexually transmitted
disease.
Oh, boy.
Imagine having to go call all your old ex-girlfriends to tell them you have ball ants.
Hey,
honey, check your balls.
You may have scorpions.
You may have scorpions.
Oh yeah, now that you mention it, I do have scorpions in my bed.
Fifth Dream Today mentioned that he got a copy of Millionaire in a box of cereal. Which I've heard about.
I remember that! I remember that we did that.
Allard, so here's something I've always wondered. Is the bald-headed dude on the cover supposed to be Cookie Masterson or Jack?
It's supposed to be nobody.
Okay, next one. The worst menu item that starts with...
You're not supposed to think about it.
Terrible question.
Oh, the more devices. Yeah,
it's not supposed to be okay. His name is Mick, and he lives in
Yugoslavia. Is that true?
Yeah, someone dug up an old interview with him from...
Yeah.
The rest of his face does not look like what you would guess.
Yeah, it's just a square. A big blocky square.
He's got... Yeah, if you actually take a look at all of the old...
That's because you did it below the...
Using only two words, a new state motto for Texas.
I'm going to.
It's voting time.
I don't know.
I'm happy that mine is about as bad as the other one. I feel like we equally put the same amount of effort into this.
I was going to say something terrible.
Kind of Texas. Texas is doing LA. Just fine.
Texas doesn't need your charity. Oh, well, based on the audience, is that how it works?
Yeah.
Coming
up right. Next, something you do twist not want me. To do while standing in a police lineup. Time to vote.
That's pretty good. Rabbit says, I have a copy of the Men in Black PC game from like 1997. I have no idea where I got it from. Also good information.
When you got it, did they like use one of those memory wiping things about how you bought it?
Because my next question was going to be, where did you get it?
Why do we play it?
Did you go to Recall?
Lime Green 10 Techni says, you ruined the illusion. I always picture Cookie as that bald guy. It probably didn't help that in the 2011 game, the head comes out. It comes at the screen while he's saying, hi, I'm Cookie.
Yeah. Wait. We ruined the illusion. Like, how often do you actually imagine like what Cookie looks like?
Probably drifting whenever, off to sleep.
Yeah.
In the shower.
Masturbating. Are we trying to be more subtle than that or not?
masturbating.
How dare you?
Manipulating your genitalia with your hands.
For sexual pleasure.
Yeah, to the point of ejaculation.
Yeah, if you want.
And that's all for round two. Fire up the score.
That's okay. Just don't hurt yourself.
I just need to know that for a minute.
Come on. seventh place.
Some of that's who you were. And just Vince says, the guy in the middle is Tim and he works in Jellyfish.
And all of us were in the same prompt this time.
I got the Chex Mix game used to have a full
Superman special power that he never tells anyone about.
None of the words you just said make any sense.
No, somebody asked.
I think that I have a stroke.
The cereal box games. In the Chex Mix, you used to be able to get Chex Quest.
Really?
And it was like this. It was a Doom. It was Doom, but modded to have like you shoot. You should start that somewhere. Anyway, check the button.
So were you being attacked by just like giant pieces of Melba toast or something?
It was like aliens were attacking you, and you had to you were like Chex Man. You're just do big muscle dude with like a Chex thing for a head, and you had like weapons that shot Chex at enemies and killed them.
Does anyone remember the Taco Bell PC game you could get on like a 1/4-inch floppy? 3 1/4-inch floppy. And you're like Taco Bell guy and you're collecting tacos.
Take a look.
I do remember the Burger King Xbox 360 games.
Alright. Superman King, special power.
I want to copy that.
Mold breath. The ability to grow copious amounts of hair.
That would be good.
Good with names. Pretty good. Super garlic breath. World's greatest brownie recipe. Knowing stuff about Chex Quest.
Sure.
Or genital enlargement.
I'm guessing Ryan's answer is either good with names, pretty good, or knowing something about Chex Quest.
Okay.
I feel like the Chex Quest thing, you had to be in this room. It's either you or Allard, or maybe
because
Evan.
The timing wouldn't have worked out.
Yeah.
I think that's probably Evan.
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot I had three.
I only voted for active.
Mold breath. It sucks to go first. You're like, I did the worst.
That's okay.
Pizza dog. Next time I adopt a dog, I think I'm going to name it Pizza Dog.
Pizza Dog.
Although I guess that's from Hawkeye, right? It's a reference. I just realized.
Nobody.
But you adopt a dog weekly, though.
That's true.
So you have a lot of time.
Wait, your dog gets better.
Yeah, beat you.
I was Evan.
Good call.
So I'm guessing I was right about Ryan.
You were.
All right.
Are you happy to know that? Like, was it because you understand my humor? Because you were like, this is about as good as
I when I read it, I heard it in your voice.
It makes me feel like I know you too well that it's time to really slowly back away from spending any time with you.
Okay. I was like up there.
That's all. Now for the final scores.
Jisbin suggests I change my son's name to Pizza Dog. It's I have a daughter, not a son, but maybe I will change her name to Pizza Dog.
Shut up, Jisbin. What a stupid suggestion. If he had had a son, it would make sense.
Yeah, clearly Pizza Dog is a boy's name.
Yeah.
Winner Pizza Dog.
Winner Pizza Dog. I actually...
I have a son.
Yeah.
And, you know, his name hasn't really stuck yet.
he doesn't answer to it anything.
I want to know if my dad is in the credits of this game, because I believe he backed this game at a higher level than I did.
Really? Like at the $100 level,
I think he might have done that.
Well, we can check.
Is he one of the people who didn't respond to us when we asked them what he wanted to be credited
as? No, I think he did, because he was like, wait till you see what I put, but I don't know what he put, so I may not recognize it.
This is like an inside joke.
I might remember.
Yeah, exactly.
He doesn't have a different last name.
No, he might have used some sort of...
Dalton Castle.
He might have used the name he uses for hotels. We'll see.
Wow, so now we're going to find
out.
Was it
Matt DiGiorgi?
No, that's
pretty
right.
Close.
Is it Fard Imahamid?
Fraud.
No.
I don't care.
Doesn't seem right. No question.
Jeffrey Sears? No.
That guy's just doing buzz marketing.
Yeah.
If there was a DiGiorgi in the credits, I would have noticed it.
He must.
Well, there. I saw DiGiorgi definitely responded, but I don't remember what the credit was.
Yeah, he probably put something awful. He's also a huge racist, my dad. As you mentioned,
good.
So that's a problem.
Dodger of Zion.
Why does he hate white people so much?
Yeah, I don't know. He never can get over it. Oh yeah, there it is. Former vaudeville star and current racketeer Murray Bruin. Yeah, that's an inside joke.
That's great.
Good
that's
for my dad. He got it, gave you guys $100.
Thank you.
There's
dad.
My uncle
Georgie.
Mitchell.
Wait, my mother-in-law.
Great.
My mother-in-law is here.
Order Corn is my friend from high school.
Really?
And I sent him an email. I was like, just so you know, I don't know if you did this on purpose. Like, but your credit in the game is
Order Corn. And he was like, yes.
And he responded with some very confusing, cryptic message that didn't actually get to the answer.
He responded with, so like, he responded with, beef sidewalk. Send.
Is he having a seizure all the time?
At that point, it was like, whatever.
My mother-in-law is in there somewhere. She's credited as Ben's mother-in-law.
Yeah.
Yeah, Greg Gretsch.
I'm good for now.
I'm okay for the time being.
I'd love some more taffy to put into my hoodie pocket.
Yeah. We could get Arnie some things. For people just to
practice.
Are we
going to play another game now? We're going to like take a break and do something else? Or
should... What do we want to do?
What do we want to do? Should we listen to a bit of the story? Ryan?
Yeah, let's do
it.
This is
one of my favorite things.
I'm leaving it.
Yeah, you got to get out of here.
Yeah, that's probably best.
It's very graphic.
It's true.
So...
Man, this room cleared out fast.
Yeah.
You are really unpopular.
I should mention, thanks a lot to Brandon Eels, who heard this story elsewhere and decided to use it on Reading Out Loud, which is his great podcast.
Yeah.
He does with many other people.
Highly recommend his Reading Out
it's
Loud
podcast.
Podcast. It's really great.
So he had some awesome professional voice actors read my story.
And if you start listening to it, and if you, I think he's also on Twitter, follow Reading Out Loud on Twitter and tell him the Jackbox game sent you.
Yeah.
So we'll listen to the beginning of it.
Since
there's no visuals along with it. Can we hear this?
No, that's okay. It's a silent story.
It was perfect beach weather, and here I was at a cemetery.
Since it's about dogs, I thought we'd just...
I should clarify that I love going to the beach when it's raining. That way I can run up and down the shore pretending that I'm falling in love in an independent movie and I don't even care how wet I'm getting. My point is, it was raining and I was at a cemetery. I was there to bury Roger, my best friend in the world. I should also clarify that Roger was a dog. I want to make that clear so that when I tell you how we've known each other since we were young, lived together for years, took long walks together and all that stuff, you don't think I'm talking about another person. I guess it could be funny if you made that assumption and then I said I was really talking about a dog, but that's the kind of shoddy narrative structure that could really confuse what I think is going to be a great story. Now that I think about it, I guess I could have also clarified that I was at a pet cemetery before, but at some point you just have to accept your mistakes and go on.
DBZ says, ready for game two.
As I stood in the rain, staring at Roger's grave, I thought about all the good times we'd had together. Playing fetch, running up and down beaches in the rain. Dog stuff, mostly. He'd been moving slower lately, and when he stopped moving entirely and started smelling terrible, I suspected the worst. What had been a surprise was the turnout for the funeral. Besides me, about 30 others had come to mourn Roger's passing. Some of them were other dogs, which I guess made sense. Roger must have his own friends outside the house. But a lot of them were people, and I didn't recognize any of them. I hadn't invited anyone besides myself, which may have explained why they all stood several yards away and quickly hid behind tombstones when I glanced
at them. They know I need the extra help.
I was trying to figure out a polite way to ask about this when someone behind me spoke.
Mr. Jones?
Yeah.
Said the voice.
Think about it.
Yes, I said.
Terribly sorry for your loss.
I turned to see a tall man in a long black overcoat, black hat, and black gloves, wearing black-rimmed glasses and holding a black umbrella. The only thing about him that wasn't black were his eyes, which were a cool, steely gray. Also, he was a white guy. How did you know my dog? I asked, trying to make small talk.
All right.
It so happens that I am an attorney for the deceased.
So a weird guy shows up at the funeral. What happens next? It's a cliffhanger.
But we encourage you all to go to readingoutloud.org and listen to the rest of the story. It's really... I laughed out loud many, many times the first time I heard it.
It's a better story to listen to when you don't want to play a video game instead.
That's true. There's some great voice acting by some Chicago voice actors as well, including, I realize, Steve Kometko, who used to be the host of E! News Daily, like, back in the day.
Oh, really?
That's a name you don't forget.
I know.
I don't know.
Hey, you guys.
Yeah?
Look at this.
Oh, looks like we have somebody... Outside our door.
The Jizzy Binner apparently is taking pictures of our door and then tweeting about it.
Oh.
Hmm.
So he's...
That's terrifying.
Is this how we tie?
let's send Ryan out to
it's
find
good.
Out.
I'm glad to know that I was here for the end.
Right Ash says, Ben is back. I love you. And Jordy...
Those are one sentence. Ben is back. I love you.
And Jordy Baby says, I missed the barbecue cam.
Yeah, we still have the cam, but now it's looking at the floor.
There's no barbecue.
But hey, let's check it out.
Yeah, let's check out the barbecue. I wish there was barbecue on the floor.
Roll that beautiful bean footage.
There it is. Ooh, that's my foot. Oh!
Great. Now, why does that exist?
This is so we could play card games and stuff.
Oh, great. Okay.
And show people barbecue.
Gotcha.
All right. Let's play. Should we play a dating game or should we play Quiplash?
Let's play a dating game and then we'll do a game of Quiplash at the end. So... This game, I don't know much about.
Adcool says, I'm actually outside too.
No! Nobody answered the damn door when
it's like the Letterman show. A bunch of people are like the Today show.
God, I have work to do after this, but I'm going to be stuck here for a while. I can just tell.
You don't get...
I'm kidding.
You don't get to leave.
I know. I'll say hi. I don't care.
Yosup says, dating games are stupid.
Another freaking...
Not this one, though.
Another Unity game.
This game is called Hot Date.
A bunch of blood. You can't skip this.
Do you think that's really his name?
Yeah, Greg. What, Bachelor? That's something Bachelor?
Yeah, Greg seems pretty like a pretty dumb word. Everyone's outside your door.
You should play it. We're going to play Hateful Boyfriend at some point.
Oh, someone's in the room right now.
Huh? What's your name? What's our name gonna be?
Are we a dog or a human dating a dog? That's, I feel like, important for naming the character.
Well, let's ask this chat.
What should we name ourselves?
The next person who chats is gonna be the name.
Yep. Oh, God.
Dry Dash.
All
right. There you go. Little Rye Dash. Oh, that's adorable. This dog has a cat, which I enjoy.
What if it was Yo? What if we said Yo?
Yo.
Oh, God, are you cool? I'm tragically uncool.
No.
Is that a girl, though?
It's pink.
You're on a date.
So,
let me see the neck.
Color normative.
Yeah, let's see the
neck. I know. I guess Frankenberry was pink, and Frankenberry.
Yeah. What? He did a lot for that color. What a noise. Oh.
What you do for fun?
Maybe we should shut the door. It's getting a little loud in the office.
She's in the gym.
Can you also bolt the door?
Yeah. This is gonna be like where everyone.
This is already more interesting than any OK Cupid data.
Wait, wood? Let's see what's wood.
Wood?
Wood?
You like to see my collection of.
Mm-hmm.
Would you like to travel back in time? Oh.
Oh.
Yeah. Would you ever travel back in time?
Only forward.
Sorry. Oh.
Yeah.
It's like way to ruin our date, aren't you?
Like an Obama dog.
We're never gonna get laid.
Step out of it, hippie dog.
Let's see if we can get out of this date as fast as possible.
And onto some dog living? Is that what you mean? You ever thought about changing your
weighs.
Name?
Ask how much she weighs.
Ryan Dash says boring, and then he says next dog.
Next dog.
Bellini?
She wasn't interested.
Not yeah, terrible
this
question.
Dog is not bringing much to the table.
Yeah.
Why don't you ask a question, Doug?
Do you have a bucket list?
Do you have any special skills?
Liam Neeson, Doug?
So I'm really trying to figure out this location. So there's a fancy candelabra on the table, but then there's like a cheap...
Speed dating.
A cheap, like, stand-up light, like, in the corner.
Also, there's, yeah. there's a banner that says dating.
Yeah.
It looks like it could be in a gym.
I think it's a slow dating. It says speed dating. It's just, like, early.
Slow dating.
You, like, have an hour with each person. What is going on up there?
I like the candle animations, though.
Have. Oh, no.
Have.
Yeah, have you been to one of these before? Because I don't know what these are.
A million totes.
Totally totes. Oh, now I feel bad. This dog just needs some...
Can we just get him to leave?
Yeah, that's the one to pick.
Oh!
We'll never know the answer.
Dating. You got... What's the objective?
I never want to see
I never want to see this dog again. I'm sorry.
Oh.
Great, good. Oh. That's fine. You know what? Life's too short.
Wait, is it a new dog?
We both know what we want.
Oh, wait. Oh. The dog looks the same.
Come on.
This is bullshit. This is
yeah.
Like... Same dog.
Hey, same dog. You have a cat named Same Dog?
So wait a second. Are we different? So it's the same dog. We're just different.
Yeah.
Right?
It is.
No, she said her name was Barbarella this time.
Oh.
Tell her, ask about her because I want like her to talk for a while.
I'm really boring.
Dogs can't whistle.
Okay. That's interesting. Okay, I'm kind of...
Interesting.
No. No.
Do you live around here? Let's just go.
She just rolled her eyes at us. She just rolled her eyes at us.
Do I look like I live around
here? I don't know.
What's the rudest thing you can say to this dog right now?
Are you a fan of...
You local?
Ask if they're.
Wait, no. This is important. Ask if they're local and see if she says she is. Like, do they have awareness of the fact she doesn't live around here? Okay, this is just.
Is she kidnapped?
Yeah.
Ask her if she's into new episodes of The Simpsons.
Are you a fan of.
Yeah.
Ha! Oh.
No, wow. I mean, you know.
Wow.
What?
Got a lot of time for Grandpa.
For Grandpa Simpson? You're just wrong. This is like talking to one of those chat bots in the 90s where they like sort of sound like they might know what you're saying, but really they don't.
Yeah, it really hasn't gotten any better.
No. Yeah, but also we're not writing our own things. They should have responses to these questions that make sense.
So says a interactive writer.
As an interactive media writer. Right.
Guys, as EOF says in the chat, that dog is not ready for a meaningful relationship, so.
Okay.
Oh, we have a list of jokes.
Fifth Dream today says, papers, please.
Papers, please, please. Yeah, Dr. Spitzo. That's exactly right, Raz.
Is this like talking to Alex at Jellyvision?
I feel like...
This is a little better.
There's something that's compelling about this game a little bit, but I feel like what it's missing is a button where you could just commit suicide at the table.
The dog wouldn't react to it.
Is there like an old yellow button?
Thinking about me. Is she ready to commit? All right. Can we get some food here?
This is speed dating. There's no food.
Oh, I guess, yeah.
It's just shame.
Has anyone here ever done speed dating?
I've not done speed dating.
Have you ever read...
It's a thing?
Speed dating is a thing.
Yeah.
Here in
the you've never heard of speed dating?
I've been married since I was like 22.
Yeah.
You go and date like
now.
For whatever, like 3 minutes or something, a bunch of different people.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Is she
I've never
response?
Done it, but...
Was that a good response?
Well, we're almost out of time, so...
How do you know?
Has anyone in the chat been speed dating? I'm gonna wait for a while, I guess.
So when we're out of time, we're just gonna get another identical dog.
If there's any different looking dog...
Well, how
is it in
this one?
I
wanna fuck this dog.
Oh.
Oh, man.
Buddy Speed 13 says speed dating is actually quite fun if you're just looking for an interesting evening.
Yeah, that's what I imagine. I'm married, so I have no real reason to go speed dating, but I feel
but
like...
You do anyway.
But I do it.
What if you did it together?
But we all sit at the same table. With
Let's all go. Yeah.
We all just get the entirety of Jackbox games.
We're looking for a lot of different things.
What if we treated the stream like speed dating, and then every 5 minutes everyone had to leave and a new chat group had to come in?
That would probably be good for marketing.
Fuck that chat group.
Let's play something else.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, here, this might be a good opportunity to listen to. Okay, that's there.
This is a good segue into Hoofs of Love.
The perfect cup of coffee. Another, that's what we pour at High Horse Coffee House. But it's not for everyone.
Another commercial featuring Ryan.
I have a very brief part in this one, but it's thematically appropriate.
Yeah. So this is Hoofs of Love.
On the season premiere of Hoofs of Love. 18 women living in a house competing for the love of one famous horse.
Oh my god, he was in that movie Hidalgo? He was the one that wasn't Viggo Mortensen.
Who's up for body shots?
But it's not just fun and games, because all's fair in love and horse.
Most of these women are here to drink and be on TV. But for me, it's real. I'm falling in love with that horse.
Sorry, I am not here to make friends. I am here to f*** a horse.
And it's all part of one horse's crazy journey to find love in L.A.
I'm afraid there's only one saddle left. Will it go to Tamara or Nikki?
Oh my gosh, pick me, pick me, pick me.
Ugh, let it be me.
Don't say nay.
That bitch better get off my horse.
It's time for an all-new season of Hoofs of Love. This horse is not just back, he's bareback.
My wife is also in that one. Although she is not the one that wants to fuck a horse. Well, I guess technically all the women in that do want to fuck a horse, but she doesn't come out and say it.
Which one?
She might be the one who's falling in love with the horse.
I think, really? Yeah, I think, yeah.
That's great.
It didn't sound like her.
I didn't recognize
her. She is an actor.
Yeah.
She's
sort of an actor.
It's true.
Wait, Tom is the jizz bin? Tom who? The fuck are you talking about?
Oh boy, okay. Let's play another game.
There's a lot of twist endings occurring.
Yeah.
Just like catching up on Slack here, like this has obviously caused a bit of a ruckus in the back. The Jizbin has been stalking us.
Uh-huh.
And it could possibly be one of our own.
Wait, it really?
I don't know.
Oh, but, that'd be fun. Like Tom?
He posted a picture outside the door.
Okay.
Not Tom Healy.
Oh, that's what I was wondering.
No, there's a new Tom here.
How much does Evan cost?
A lot.
I'll tell you, I've been here for 3 years and Evan's never...
Never put out.
You don't know what I do in my free time.
Yeah, that is a good question that I've often wondered. That prospective fellow asks, is Allard a horse?
Mm-hmm. That was top 5 creepiest laughs ever.
No, that was like Ron Swanson's weird giggle that he sometimes has on Parks and Rec.
I tried to make it a whinny laugh.
Who wants to get in this game of Quiplash? Anyone?
I would like to.
Do it.
I'm going to watch this time.
The Big Shakuna wants to hire Evan to watch his stand-up comedy, which I think is a service that you do offer.
Yeah, I guess I'll laugh, too. I can laugh loudly.
I'll play this one. I haven't played
Quiplash
in a few weeks.
I've been told by many friends when I go to their shows that they heard me laughing.
You are a boisterous laugher.
If you install the Jackbox.tv site to your desktop in Android or iOS, you get like a neat full screen version.
Yeah.
I don't think we've really advertised that.
What have I done wrong? Oh, I went to a wrong site.
Oh, so did I. Damn it.
Oh boy.
We have some test sites.
Come
that we use
on,
here.
Guys. Who made the game?
Evan is the Illuminati.
That's actually the problem.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, that does make sense.
Or does it?
No,
that was mysterious.
I'm trying to join.
All right, the first letter is Y.
The Jizbin wants to know if you can cry on command, Evan, which I think is a good question.
That's not good to know since he's outside our door.
Oh, no.
Or do I have to make you cry? The second letter is G.
And the last two are the main character from Grand Theft Auto San Andreas.
Or you can just read it as Yigajish. See if anybody can figure
it out. So YG.
Yigajish. Yeah.
Who is your favorite Jackbox fan? Let's start with Arnie. Who's your favorite fan?
You better say it's the Jizbin right now.
Yeah, look how many people figure it out from Yigajish. Or maybe from
CJ. The CJ. My favorite Jackbox fan is probably myself, because I consider myself a fan. Also, I hate everyone that's not me.
My favorite Jackbox fan is Arnie's mom. is a fan of anything.
My mom is pretty adorable. My mom spent probably more money on word putts than anyone else besides this company. I had to actively tell her to stop.
We just had like a weird smattering of views on Facebook for our WordPress page. Like 30 views and likes.
Huh.
Somebody out of the bot.
Was it?
So when the game goes to sleep, there's nothing we can do about it.
This is PS4, so we don't have that problem.
Ryan, you can start here now. Do it.
Do you want me to?
Let's do it.
Great. Do it. 3, 2, 1.
Turn the volume up, God.
Oh, 2004 man wants a code again. What are we gonna do? We're gonna consume like 2 months now.
Hi, I'm Shmitty, which is Norwegian for
Quiplash. No.
Amazing coincidence. Okay, did everyone turn in their permission slips?
Well, if you backed Quiplash, you'll get a code in your email in a couple weeks.
This is round one. You'll score points based on the percentage of people.
That would be great. We'd love to have your mom on.
We have the dead.
Do your parents come and visit often?
I'll try to
see you. Volume 2 normal. Let me fix that. Next time, please post the first 3 parts of the room code in chat. Well, thought we'd try it a little different this time. But we will do that next time. What else is going on, chatters?
What else can I tell you about myself?
Is this still a test server? What's the URL? No, this is on the live server now. The URL is just jackbox.tv. This is pretty much the game that you're gonna get. You do you, Evan. Thanks. I learned that lesson from the movie Drumline. It's a great movie. Nobody tell me how to do me.
Shorties to the left of me. Doggone shorties to the right of me. That was a lot.
Stuck in the middle with you.
I also had one of my favorite lines, which was, whatever the beef is between you two, you better grill it up and eat it.
Nick Cannon really, really nailed that. Nick Cannon really nailed that one.
That was Orlando Jones delivered that gem.
When I saw the movie, I was seeing a look. So I was like,
starting things off, a college major, you
were
don't
you actively
see
in a drum line?
That's what I assumed.
God, I can't believe it. There. I saw this movie with the drum line here. Did you have one band, one sound? Let's see, a college major. Oh, I didn't.
Poodle Parker's asking for your number.
Yeah.
It's like Jizbin is trying to break in from the ceiling.
What a Quiplash that was!
Oh boy,
nicely done,
dog. Yeah, Poodle Porker says, Evan, your hair is enjoyably curly. What's your number?
You guys want a number?
My sleep number? It's 4.
4-7.
I think he wants to pork your poodle-like hair.
Four tots.
I have a poodle.
It's voting time.
Oh god!
I don't know where that's going. So stay away from my house, please.
Jizbin's already there.
Good thing you're moving soon.
He's such a cute little dog.
Good thing you're moving to the following address.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, Poodle Porker Lane.
Oh, me against Harris Foster.
Ooh.
Crushed it.
Nice.
Wait, so did Dave Lang know who Harris Foster was?
I believe Dave Lang has met Harris Foster before, but Harris Foster is stiff competition in this game.
What we know is that he is a human turd.
The real reason the dinosaurs die.
It's a choice.
Oh, now there's a fight in the chat between the Jizbin and Poodle Porker over Evan.
Oh, God.
It's gonna be
awkward. Ladies, the lady office today.
I am taken. I'm going to prom tonight.
Oh, you're really?
Yeah.
That's great.
My wife's a teacher. We're going to prom. No. I have to go get a corsage or something, I guess. I don't know how prom works.
Weird.
I know. Well, she is going to be one of many prom dates at this prom that has a kid.
Lady Gaga, that crazy outfit, a blank dress.
She got a lot of pregnancy advice from her students.
That's kind of adorable.
Yeah.
Yeah, but also.
Clan guess.
Yes, agreed.
No, we're not going in a limo to prom.
Because Farada actually has that.
Shorty Baby's prom was last night. How'd it go?
Don't get Paul in.
It's true. Nobody wants it.
Don't get Paul in.
Oh, God.
Or Scorpion.
Next up, the first thing you would do after winning the lottery.
Dance that golden wood. My jackbox. Second thing to go bankrupt.
Oh,
step ahead of you there.
We're doing that just fine.
Yeah.
No. No one's not mine.
A period and a colon. But no open, but an open sense at the end.
I voted for Frank Tanz.
I just started listening to Real Big.
Oh, really? Fish is great.
Yeah, I
love that band.
I've never really listened to Real Big. I've always assumed
they're too technical.
They're what? You catch it.
Do
you like Scott at all?
I do not.
Well,
that's
then,
why.
Yes, they're not.
Stop it.
It's all done.
Stop dropping plop is funny.
Yeah.
But not enough. Did Jordy Baby ever say if he got laid? That's what I really want to know.
It's important. I want one of our games to get someone laid at some point, but no one's ever admitted it.
Yeah, you've brought that up a lot.
Like, did somebody got engaged.
Just like once a month.
Somebody got engaged with a special game of Jack, right?
That's
true. I must have gotten laid after
that. The really awkward, five-minute makeout session we recorded after her.
That was
amazing.
We should have edited that down a little bit.
She had wet hair.
You're revealing a lot about what you are into.
The original video has like a 5-minute makeout. It's really weird.
See, they fucked. Come on, that's you win.
That's Alex's ringtone now. It's just
the sloshy sound of the makeout.
Ooh, Ryan beat me.
It's the only time.
Scro Turkey is good.
Coming up next, title for the next awkward teen sex movie.
Yeah, that's the nice thing. You don't feel bad.
Time to vote.
Wow.
Nice.
I think that's a Lifetime movie.
King Bohico says his girlfriend gave him head because of the Jackbox incident. I would like to know more about that incident.
Jackbox
incident. Did you,
what a destruction!
She was nicely done.
Ben.
Nicely done, Ben.
Really destroyed Harry Foster. Harry Foster is off his game this time.
Maybe it's not really Harry Foster.
Did your girlfriend find out you backed Quiplash and gave you that?
Did she just want to do anything other than play the game?
You know what? Given that.
Dalton.
I'm doing better this time at least.
Round two is straight ahead. All right. That means
so that would probably be a good example of a question that's not in family friendly mode.
Sure.
I would imagine. We should ask Steve-O.
UF321 says, take it, Ben, which I like to take as a violent request.
Let's see what
so
we got.
Just been like playing on our stairs now? What's going on?
I think it's a magic.
The call is coming from inside.
I'm guessing it's pictures from like whenever his friend delivered them.
Well, there has been a lot of construction in the building, so we can tell.
I can tell you.
It'd be like Ocean's 11.
Did we ever post that picture like on our blog or something?
I'm not going to give details, but it wasn't hard to get in here.
Yeah, well, you didn't buzz in. You just showed up at the door.
Yeah, so.
He just looks really innocent and non-murdery.
I am Jizbin.
Can you help me find my mom? She's in there.
No, I am Jizbin.
No, I.
How many questions are officially in Quiplash?
A lot.
Yes.
It's also infinitely replayable, so you see the same question again after, you know, a couple months. Then
and then you steal the funniest answer with it was in that game.
Guys, better. Yeah. Dragon Ball Z Wii 09 just derp big time.
What?
One more.
He was like 15. He was really into Dragon Ball Z and Nintendo. He was like.
Sounds like someone I know.
Okay, it's time for some quiplashing. First one, the sound a tree actually makes when it falls and no one is around to hear it. Okay, voting time.
I'll see a lot of answers get better if we just add a question.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good... It's like adding a little Mrs. Dash to your answer.
I didn't do it this time, but also since I'm just adding comma right question mark, better answer.
All right, team.
Yeah. Harris Foster making a comeback with a strong quiplash.
I was one of the five people who voted for the other one.
Boy.
Next in line.
Yeah, ball ants question mark is a good answer to pretty much anything.
Why can't you go out tonight? Ball
ants? Express! No!
That's nice.
No!
I like calling it the Panda Bear Express.
Fun story about it.
To me, that's like a train run by Panda Bear.
I think I didn't do super great in this one. I did better than I thought I would.
User with no name asks you if that was a Fables reference.
It was not, although I actually do love the comic book series Fables. It's one of my favorite things.
I haven't read it yet, but I hear it's great.
Next
it's coming to an end soon.
What's
if it
the Mona Lisa
already.
Smiling about?
It's
voting done.
I'm the trade, but I'll do it digitally.
Oh, yeah? I like Comixology quite a bit. Is that where you have it?
No, it's just...
Oh, you just have it digitally?
Yeah.
I see.
Play all the trade paperbacks.
Mm-hmm. All right.
So low brow.
I'm surprised there's no Roger reference in here.
Yeah, well, we'll fix that before. No, no, don't worry. I submitted a bug.
I emailed Microsoft and told them, let's hold off on this.
Yeah, that explains a lot.
You're going to need to pull that out of submission.
What's this TRC that says... We need a Roger reference.
I'm not sure I want to answer vote for either of these.
Somebody draw what an Enos Paste jar looks like. A jar of Enos.
So draw that, put it in an envelope, set it on fire, and walk away.
Give it to Jiz Ben to deliver it to the door. Yeah, I won.
Battle of the Rise.
Battle of the R-Wise. That was a battle of attrition, though, really. Neither of us.
Sport idea, professional blank. Time to vote.
Fapping.
These are about the same.
Yeah, cool.
Unless you're fapping outside.
Poodle Porker says anus paste clearly comes in a tube, which is probably right.
Yeah, that's true. Okay.
Are you guys all the makers of Jackbox games?
It's just these three guys and me. Yeah. Four guys.
We make the company, and the company makes the games.
I forgot.
Thanks, Ryan, for denying me a quiplash.
Okay,
yeah, no problem.
Perfect name for a second head. That's
well, I just wanted to encourage
shoulder.
You to do your A, do your best work.
Just really.
Now you have a new title.
Foster. Dalton was already winning by a lot.
Wow.
Harris Foster is the worst. Dave Lang was right.
Next, I like that.
The worst breakfast pancakes shaped like blank.
Yeah, I think you're right.
I'd eat all of these pancakes.
Pancakes shaped like waffles or waffles. Everyone on the screen works at Jellyvision. Sure.
Yeah, in like a broad meta sense.
At some point, except for
that. We all worked at Jellyvision. Some of us still
No, I guess that's true.
The Jellyvision family of companies.
Some of us are on the dark side of
next
the forest.
Next in line,
but...
a bad reason to call 911. It's voting time.
You're like the bat of the animal world.
If you put a question mark after it.
Yeah. I feel like I would have voted for it if it was my dick, comma, right?
I'm still voting for it.
I like to put the same thing for both things, sometimes just to see it.
So that's like the equivalent of your tip guide, the cheat guide equivalent.
Not balls.
Oh, right.
Damn it.
You got two balls. Look at that.
Jellyvision made worms, too. Sure, let's just say things.
I don't know, did you like worms too?
How would you describe the taste of the points that the little Quiplash dudes are eating? That's a good question.
They taste like delicious Sheila G's brownie bites.
Wait,
our sponsor today.
Turn it off. It looks like, no, so they can get back in it.
The back?
Yeah. It has like this woman that this sort of looks like three, it's like the book cover of the book. And
yeah, she does look very happy about her brownies.
One single prompt this time. Can I try one?
Anus Paste needs to be a new last title and drop. Get on it.
Okay.
A realistic, honest fast food slogan.
Where did you get this idea from to this game? Well,
how did we get the idea from to the game? Let's see.
This game, we kind of got it from playing Fibbage a lot, actually. So we'd play Fibbage and
we troll.
People would want to put in the most ridiculous answers and just make people laugh, but then you lose the game because it's obviously not the right answer, so no one votes for you. So we thought it would be fun to have a game where you were encouraged to put in the craziest answers possible. And here it is.
We made a game that lets you play like you want
back. I don't know if that's exactly the story.
It's not bad. But we were trolling.
All right, here's the board. Vote with your votes now.
No answer.
Anus Paste should not be a wrong answer of the game, and you don't know Jack 2017.
A realistic, honest fast food slogan. Someday you're gonna die, right? Or you're gonna die someday, right? Sell, it's fresh, all day, our bathrooms smell better than the food.
I think I might know what Arnie's one was.
It's food, right? My dick.
Someone's hammering my dick home until I vote for it.
Oh, boo. I hate this like that image.
Hammering my dick home to the image of your new album?
Yeah, that's actually, yes.
That'll go in dirty drop.
Yeah, one vote.
I was actually distracted and did not vote at all.
So what's next for Jackbox Games after Quiplash? Don't pretend you're not sure yet. You owe us some.
You owe us answers.
Whoa.
We know exactly what we're doing, and we're working on it.
Your mind is going to be blown.
It's more games.
And insurance products.
We're going straight into the anus paste business.
We're actually making a companion app for Amazon Instant Streaming to help you figure out what to watch.
We're developing STDs.
Settle. I give it all three of my votes.
How is that not you?
Not me. I think mine maybe got no votes.
That's the end. Let's
Harris
see the
Foster
final
says
scoreboard.
This was not my game.
I think Dalton took it.
Are you actually Dave Lang playing as Harris Foster?
What a big finish, Arnie!
Crap. Yeah, it's no fun when I'm.
Are you guys going to have a picture meme game? I'm waiting on that one.
Sure.
Someday. How do the matchups work if there's an odd number of players, Ben? You want to talk about that? How people are matched up?
There's an even number of matches all the time because you do two rounds.
There you go.
Bam! Sorry.
Alright. Well, we've gone a little long.
Yeah.
But this is fun.
Yeah, thanks for coming around, Ryan.
Except for that terrible hot day game, which I thought was disappointing.
It was disappointing.
And Ryan, who was kind of disappointing.
I would say so-so.
Yeah. If I was like alone at home, I'd play with it.
Play Hot Date? Yeah.
Cut to Ben tonight for 3 hours.
Ben was the person in the back row yelling out what we should ask questions about. Like, hey, do the Simpsons question.
Look, if anybody can have sex with an artificial intelligence.
You're going to have sex with that dog, Ben. We believe in you.
Hey, Rydash, we'll see you next week. Make sure to say hi to me and Ryan.
That's right.
Let us know.
We have no idea what you look like.
Don't disappoint us. We have a lot of expectations.
Eric asks, is this on PS4 or PS3? It will be on both.
Yeah, cross buy.
Is it?
I don't know. I feel like every couple weeks, someone's like, wait, is this cross buy? And then everyone says, yes.
And we'll see if Sony does it. Yeah. Are we going to do a Vita version as well?
No. Vita's gone.
Booyah?
I love my Vita.
All right.
Yeah. Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Jackbox Games Twitch stream.